MedTrack allows for diagnosis centers to interact with all other players in the health ecosystem. And so it allows for laboratories and then for radiology centers to receive electronic requests from physicians to interact with the patients directly, counsel patients on the preparations they need to make before they come for these tests to be done. And they are able to then also interact with the doctors and to make specifications, to ask for specifications for the various tests that have been requested. And at the end of the day, they are able to upload the laboratory investigations for easy access by the physicians. And also, it gives them a database of lab reports that they've sent out for particular patients and for particular lab tests. So this is a walkthrough of the diagnosis center's dashboard. So we'll sign in our diagnosis center. And then this shows us a dashboard. It shows us the main processes within a laboratory. So first, a prescription comes, a request comes in, and that goes into a queue. Then when the request is being acted on, it goes in progress, and when the report is sent out, it goes to sent. So this, the default page is usually on the queue, because that's the first point of access to the laboratory. And if you open our patient Omar file, we are able to access Omar Farouk's information and contact information. So his email address is up here and then his phone number for us to be able to contact Omar Farouk and schedule a time for the investigation to be done. And if there are any preparations that need to be made by Omar Farouk, that will also be done. And we can access the physician's information. So the physician attending to him on the 24th of June. The physician is Dr. Clarence. We can then access Dr. Clarence's facility, his phone number, and then his email address, and contact him if there's any discussion we need to have with him. Then the investigations requested for are summarized, and if the doctor had any attachments, he uploads them. Then when samples and specimens are taken for investigations to be done, we start with commence examination. When this is clicked on, then the patient moves from a queue to the in-progress section. So if you click on in progress, it gives us another list of patients whose investigations are being done actively. So again, we use our patient Omar Farouk. This tells us of an interaction we had on the 13th of May, and his physician again was Dr. Clarence, and these are the investigations that were requested for. But in the in progress section, where you, if you scroll down, you see that the lab investigations have been itemized and isolated, which means that at any point, if any of them is completed, that can be clicked off, and then at the bottom of this, the report can be attached, and then the reports can be sent. And when the reports are sent, the patient then moves from in progress to the sent report list. If you open Omar Farouk, the report of his that has been sent is from an interaction from the 2nd of June 2021. Again, these are the list of laboratory investigations requested for. Again, go on to our patient Omar Farouk. This is a list of lab tests that has been requested. And if you scroll to the bottom, the attachments. So these are the reports that have been uploaded. We click on any of them, but the report uploads and then the doctor has access to this information. And the laboratory has also has access to this information at all times. They would have access to a continuation of patients' reports, and then the laboratory physicians are able to look at the pattern of investigation that the patient has done and are able to give a more comprehensive analysis of what the patient's health condition is and advise the physicians appropriately. Thank you.